Is there some bit of feeling of revenge?
No.
Beating these guys?
No. New year, Coach Saban taught me that. It's a new team. So this was really about us continuing to learn to try to be the hunted. And we knew that with UNA losing against Union today, that this put us in first place. And these kids really wanted it. And, you know, I'm trying to be patient with them. And they are stretching it, but they're making plays. We did a great job defensively in the second half, you know, to hold them to 31%. We wanted to win the boards. We did that. We wanted to outshoot them. We did that. And, we wanted to make more free throws than they took, and we did that. I thought we were aggressive. Some people may look at the box score and go, well, that's home cooking. That's not home cooking. That's a taking it right at people. We knew that they didn't have depth. We were going to go right at 20. We were going to go right at 23. You can beat 23 off the bounce. We knew that. And so we were going to take her off the bounce. So, for us, I just think it was a team that really wanted to get a win, and they all played a role.
You weren't real thrilled after Thursday's game. You must have come back and had a pretty good day of practice yesterday, and girls buying in and things like that.
Actually, welcome to coaching women. We did very little on the court. We watched film. We talked about what we had to do. I walked them through Delta sets, and we shot, and we got out. It was a really short practice because they knew that the problem wasn't schematic, that it was them, that they weren't getting in passing lanes, they weren't being aggressive. And I think we finally saw that tonight. And not all the kids, every kid that played tonight weren't perfect, but they made plays when they needed to make plays, and that's what I'm probably most proud of.
A little bit like the other night too, somebody different, maybe not, obviously Jordan played well, Jazz had another big game, but now Bailey comes up and made a big shot for you then, got a big rebound the other end. She seemed like she really contributed.
Yep. She was sick before Thursday, and if you remember Thursday, she came out and took 5 shots early. She was really aggressive. She was 0-for-5, and I felt like if we could get one of those to go in, that Katie barred the door and the floodgates would open, and they didn't. But we also thought she came out so hard that she got a little winded. It was in her chest. It was a cold. And so we felt like, okay, and again, yesterday she rested. We had the lighter practice, and then we came back, and she was a little healthier today. She said at the shoot-around she felt good, and she knows we needed her, and she stepped up. Same with, Morgan, again, didn't stick out maybe as much as she did the other day, but she did some really good things for us.
Did you go out and run something tonight for Bailey quick to get her something?
The first play we had her in, we put a little set in that I just drew up, and that we've run a couple times this year, and I knew I'd get her open. Morgan Duncan set a great screen. We got her open, got her the ball, and got that look. And so, yeah, we try to get her going as quickly as possible.
I heard you, Coach, towards the end of the first half, tell your team that you were wearing them down. You look at the numbers, they shoot 43% in the first half. Just 31% does Delta State shoot in the second half. How big was that to what happened there at the end? Because, you pulled ahead by one on that big three, then they pushed it back up to about 5 or 6, but then it looked like they were worn out, and you take the lead for good there.
Well, there's no doubt. When they've got 5 kids that are pushing the minutes that they do, and he tried to go to his bench some, but we know our bench is deeper. You know, that's our benefit of a veteran team. With 10, we're 10 to 12 deep. Josie Saunders played tonight, and we spread the minutes out. You know, we had one kid at 33, but we got the minutes out and really put it on him in that regard, using our depth.
As you said, you learned from Coach Saban, don't worry about revenge. Do you think the girls feel a little different?
I really don't. I mean, listen, there is a mystique about Delta State that is warranted. It was one of the great programs, but now we're a couple coaches in, and they picked us first in our league. We're the best team in this league, and I'm not afraid to say that because I have kids in the locker room that believe they're the best team, they're tired of the way they played early, and because they're getting tired of the way they played early, they're starting to step up, and that's what I'm most proud of.